Why would you swallow a pill made of a poisonous metalloid? Yes.
Would it be because you got really pissed one night and then you woke up the next morning and realised you were next to Michael Winner in bed?
Well, oddly enough, until you got to that last point, one of the uses of that poisonous metalloid was as a morning after pill, but its other use was for the other end of the body. It's a metalloid called antimony, and it's a poison. But it was popular in the Middle Ages as a pill because it's very good for constipation. The weird thing about it is you'd make a pill of antimony, because it's metalloid, it'd be like, it would pass through the body. You would then rummage through your leavings and wash it and use it again.
Rummage through your leavings.
I wasn't quite sure how to put it.
I'm certainly going to use that again, though. I like that one a lot.
And these would get handed on from father to son through generations. And they'd use the same one. Because it's a rare...
Father's leavings and his father's leavings. Yeah.
This pill was good enough for your great-grandfather.
So that's the earliest example of a repeat prescription.
Yes. Oh, very good.
Big hundreds of years.
Absolutely. But the other use of it was an antimony cup where you would pour wine into it overnight when you'd had a large evening, and then in the morning you'd take the wine that had been soaked in this antimony cup, as it were, and it would make you vomit instantly. So it was used as an emetic. So it was just really...
So
it was...
what is it? It's a naturally occurring...
Yes, it's an element.
And it's an irritant, presumably? Because there's a mnemonic for remembering laxatives, which is there are bulkers, lubricants, irritants, softeners and explosives. And explosives work like cholera. You sort of stick them up your bum. That's
right.
A technical.
Or suppository, as we comedians say.
Correct. Yes.
So that's for a really serious case of being stuffed up.
Yeah, proper phosphate enema, rocket fuel. Wow. On a skateboard.
In ancient Egypt, there was a doctor whose specialised function was to administer enemas to the pharaoh. He was known as the Neru Pthuit, which literally translates as shepherd of the anus. An official job, rather pleasing.
So, with the crook, you mean?
It's obviously not a natural thing. Animals don't pump warm water up their arses, do they? It doesn't seem to happen in nature in any way that we know of. How did it come about?
Well, they are very popular with quacks. I think there's something quite attractive about how transgressive it is to squirt a lot of something up your bum that makes pretend doctors feel like real doctors. But there was a guy, well, that John Harvey Kellogg, the man behind
the
cornflake.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. So he had this big kind of quack clinic that he ran where the moment that you arrived, you had to make a visit to a man called the Rear Admiral, who would bend you over and fill you with fresh yoghurt, and then you would poo that out, and then you'd be ready to crack on with your detox.
And they would deal with your thrush at the same time.
What time's this show going out? Will people be...
Well, I mean, it is the most kind of basic fact about us all is that we poo. And also that we are, as we age, supposedly, we get more obsessed by it. I mean, it's sort of all you've got left, really, isn't it? You know, and there are stories of nurses who get sent stools by grateful patients. You must have heard those stories, eh?
They're not necessarily grateful.
It's an expression of love.
No idea why, but that habit has followed me through into my comedy career.
There was a chap recently who tried to kill somebody by... He packed his anus with explosives, and it was a Middle East prince, I can't remember which one, but he showed up and went... And his plan was, shake the guy by the hand and then trigger it. But unfortunately, the body is very good at absorbing explosions. That's why, heroic acts where people jump onto hand grenades and stuff. So all that happened was he shook this prince by the hand, and the bomb went off, and he just sort of bounced up in the air slightly and then crumpled into his knees. And the prince, like any sort of royal, just went, very good.
Oh, dear. Well, that's antimony. As I say, antimony pills were quite literally passed down through the family.